Hello students, welcome to the next day of school from home. In our previous video, we have learnt about line segment and ray. Now, in our next exercise, we will learn about the types of lines. So, there are three types of lines: parallel lines, perpendicular lines and intersecting lines. So, we will discuss about all these three lines in this exercise, and also we will discuss about angles and how to name angles. So let's begin. So now we will discuss about the types of lines. So there are three types of lines: parallel lines, perpendicular lines and intersecting lines. First is parallel lines. Lines are parallel if they are always at the same distance apart. See, AB and CD are the two lines. If they are always at the same distance apart, jahan pe bhi hum dekh le, अगर इनका डिस्टेंस सेम रहेगा हर जगह, तो हम इसे बोलेंगे पैरेलल लाइंस. दैट मींस दे आर इक्विडिस्टेंट एंड दे विल नेवर मीट. कभी भी ये जाके कहीं पे मीट नहीं करेगी. दीस लाइन नेवर टच ईच अदर. दीस लाइंस नेवर टच ईच अदर. एंड द लाइन एबी इज पैरेलल टू द लाइन सीडी. सो राइट, एबी लाइन इज पैरेलल टू लाइन सीडी. सो दिस इज अ सिंबल ऑफ पैरेलल लाइंस. यू कैन सी हियर आल्सो. So parallel lines are denoted by this symbol. Next is perpendicular line. A line is perpendicular to another if it meets or cross at right angle. See, AB and CD, they meet at right angle. 90 degree pe agar ye meet karenge, then these lines are called perpendicular lines. They form 90 degree at the point of intersection. अपने intersection के point पे वो 90 degree का angle बनाएंगे. And they are represented by this symbol. See, symbol, this is used to denote perpendicular lines. Now we can write AB line is perpendicular to line CD. So this is a symbol of perpendicular lines. Next is intersecting line. Two or more lines that meet at a point are called intersecting lines. If two lines or two or more lines are meeting at a single point, then these lines are called intersecting lines. They have one point in common, which is O. So we can say PQ intersect RS line at a point O. And you can also say that PQ line is intersecting RS line at O point. So these lines are intersecting lines. Question is angle. Angle is a figure formed by two rays. Angle kaise banta hai? Two rays. See, L, M and MN are two rays. And these rays are called the side of the angle. So this angle has two sides, L, M and M, N. Having a common endpoint, unka ek common endpoint hoga, which is M. So that common endpoint is called vertex. So angle has two sides and one vertex. See, MN and ML are the two rays which are the side of the angle, and the common endpoint of these two rays is M, and M is the vertex. So the symbol this. So we use this symbol for angles. Angle is always measured in degrees. Angles ko hum degrees mein measure karte hain. The sides of angles can also be called arms or legs. Jo sides hain, angle ki isko hum arms or legs bhi bolte hain. Next is naming an angle. So naming an angle can be done in different ways. So one way of naming an angle is using capital letters of English alphabet with the vertex alphabet in middle. See, angle, firstly we will write the symbol of angle, then angle PQR. Then PQR. Q is the vertex, it will come at the middle. Next way is only writing the vertex. We can only write the vertex. See, angle Q. And next way is assigning a numeric value. See, we have assigned a numeric value angle 1 to it. So we can write angle as angle 1. There is one more way. We can also write it as angle RQP. So there are four ways of writing or naming an angle. Question of your exercise 9.2. Name the vertex and arms or side of the following angles. You have to tell the vertex and arms. So vertex, see here. Vertex is a common point, which is T. So vertex is T. And arms are ST and T. So arms are ST and
TU. The next question also, vertex is the common point, which is H. And arms are GH and HI. So in this way, you have to tell the vertex and arms. Next question is, name the angles in four different ways. So first way is, you can write like this, angle STU. Second way is, start from this side, opposite side, UTS. Vertex will always come in the middle. Next is angle T. Only we can write in terms of vertex. And last is angle 4. We can also use a numeric value for writing angle. So these are the four ways in which you can write.
This is question angle 3 of your book.
Draw an angle of the following angles. You have to draw the angles for all three angles. See, angle H, I, J. Firstly form the symbol. Then write H, I and J. These are the arms and this is the vertex. Second is, you have to form angle R. Angle R will be like this. So this is the way to form angle R. Next is angle 2. Firstly form the symbol and then write 2. So this is the way of writing angle 2. Next, name all the angles in the figure given below. You have to name all the angles. So first write angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3. Next way is, write angle A, B, E, A, B, E. Next is angle A, B, D and next is angle A, B, C. So these are the way you can write the angle.
This, our today's explanation is over. Now, you need to solve the questions of exercise 9.2. And exercise 9.2 you will get in the form of PDF at your school website along with the set of solution. Okay, students, bye bye and take care.